In this video, we will have to talk how to subtract baseline from a given plot. So let's start with this plot. As we can see here, we are having the two column data, the x and y, and this is the plot. And it seems like decaying function, and then there is a peak, and then there is another absorption type, and we are having this plot. Now, this plot clearly seems that there is a problem of the baseline, because it is supposed to be like flat here and then going up and then here and then going down and so on. We can check here by drawing a line. So let's start to drag a line from here, means this is the zero line. So in order to remove any bend from it, click with the arrows keys, and now it is having no bending. And here I see that, let's say, in order to make it more visible, I change the color of it a little bit and the size of it. Now I can see that if this is the zero line, then this point should be at this point, and this will be baseline corrected then. So let me go for the baseline correction. Click here. And the first one, we will go to analysis, and then peaks and baseline, then peak analyzer, and then open dialog. So the menu will appear, and it will show us the preview as well. We are having two options here, create a baseline and subtract a baseline. So the first one, we will do how to create a baseline, and then in the next step, we will do how to subtract a baseline directly. So first create a baseline and then click next, and we are having the baseline mode is user defined. The method is the second derivatives for the calculation of zeros. We are having some other modes here as well, some other methods, but we will go on with the second derivative. Then we are having here the smoothing size, so we will keep it by default, which is the auto here. The threshold, which is 0.05, and this is also auto. The current number of points are actually zero, and we have enabled the auto find option. Then the number of points to find are by default 8 here, and we will go on with 8. So we will click find, and it will find the 8 points here. Now these points are actually the by default points which it has found automatically. Then we will go next, and it will create a baseline as well. Now if we are happy with this baseline, then we can go on with this. If not, then we will have to change or modify from here. So click modify if in the case we would like to modify them. And another dialog box will appear. The first point is here, which seems to be fine. The next one, let me click here and make it a little bit down and a little bit up here as well, so that we are not having it above the line. Similarly, the rest are fine, and we click done. So it has now the baseline is here, and if I want to see how my plot will look like, I will click subtract, and now my plot will be like this with a baseline subtracted. So it will means this is just to show the preview, and I will go and finish this one, and it has created the baseline for me. And over here I can look to the data. So the data is here. It has created the X column, and then it has created the baseline. If I want to see this one, it will only show me the baseline, which is this one. It's a baseline. So I would like not to plot the baseline, but I would like to plot the amplitude, and the amplitude is supposed to be baseline corrected, and this is the value which is supposed to be subtracted from this column. So I will have to generate another column here, And in this column, I will set the value of this column is, I will subtract from this column. So I go to column and here I select the amplitude and then minus, I just this B column here, I just subtract this one and I click OK and it has generated value for me. And now it is having the amplitude and this one is now the corrected one, so I can plot the corrected one and in order to see here, so this is the corrected one and it is being shown here. Let me do some changes here, like this is the amplitude and this one, this is the baseline corrected amplitude. And now I can plot this one with the actual amplitude and the baseline corrected amplitude, and let's see how it looked like. So it looks like this one. Let me correct this one. An additional legend is coming by default. So here it is. We are having the actual amplitude and then the baseline corrected amplitude. So this way we can do the first we create a baseline and then we subtract that baseline. Another way to do this thing is that I go to the file again. And now as a second method, I don't create a baseline, but I directly subtract a baseline. So I select the plot and then I go to analysis, peaks and baseline, and then I open the dialog. And the preview is here. So now I will select subtract baseline. And I just go next. Now it is saying that the baseline mode is constant and it has done a constant line here, but I will say no, it is actually user defined. As I click user defined, then the second derivatives, and these are the auto findings here, and the number of peaks are 8, which it has found here. If I am happy with this one, then I will select next. And now it has created a baseline. I can do modification as I did earlier, and if happy, I can go on next, and then I can see the preview of this, that how it will look like. It will look like this. So it's fine, and I just finish this one. And now I can see in the data that I will have no calculation required, but these are my two columns, and this one is the corrected one, and this is the baseline correction that we did in the first case. So in the previous step, we just subtracted this column from this one, and now it has done automatically in this column. So we can see that this is our actual baseline corrected plot. I can now plot both this one and this one, and I can see that this one is the baseline corrected one and this one is our actual plot. Let me change the legend. And now it is from 0 to 350, so let me change this one as well. From 0 to 350. It's basically from 10. Okay, so now we are having our plot like this. This way we can remove a baseline or can perform the baseline correction. Thank you for watching.